Hey, how you doing? Bushido Devil Dog here. It's been a while since I've uploaded a video, and during that time I've been thinking about the types of videos that I've uploaded in recent years, and it's time to put some Bushido back into the Bushido Devil Dog channel. Let's go. Find my friends, or we can go here. But this is my first time to try keto in over 15 years, so let's see how much I suck.
Positive there.
You get it?
Yep. Perfect so far, man.
よく覚えてる。
Okay, Paul. Faceless Whistle did it sprite for you. How was that? I have to say, your Taiha is very good. You forgot nothing, pretty much. It was like...
I'd say overall, yeah, I remember the general, most the important major steps.
It's very good.
It's the details. But yeah. Then again, with Kyudo, the death is in the details.
Yeah, so it's true.
Yeah. So, I mean, just one little slight variation here and there makes a huge difference.
Yeah, that's right.
So...
You did so good.
Yeah, it comes back, you know, I remember the overall movements, you know, but I know there was a few things that I got the timing off or I wasn't 100% confident, yeah. Am I doing it right? Of course, you know, have these guys, you know, help me out and say, okay, I know you did this, you should have done this, but we'll get it tuned back up quickly.
Yeah, I think you're going to have no problem.
Yeah, but, you know, the biggest thing, like I said, I probably mentioned in my previous videos that my shoulder has been the showstopper for pretty much anything, yeah. You know, because where it's been bothering me, you know, right in through this area, I could not lift higher for the longest time.
Yeah.
And doing anything, Iaido, you know, Kyudo, Aikido, you use that muscle pretty much for everything.
Yeah, it's true.
And so, you know, it really just basically killed my training for years and years, but now... I really didn't do anything, it just seemed to kind of go away,
okay.
You know, chilled out on its own, so hopefully it'll stay killed, hear that, hopefully it'll be pretty cool, and so I can get back into training and doing the martial arts that I want to do,
yeah.
So I mean, I'm in Japan, the place to do it,
that's
so,
right.
You know, so hopefully this will be the starting day of getting back into Kyudo and then on to the other martial arts as well.
Awesome, man.
So it feels good to be back.
Yay, good job.
This is a really nice dojo we're at, by the way. It's a sports center dojo, so you're going to hear other people running and training. There's a basketball gym, so you probably hear that noise in the background. But it's really nice, and it feels good to be back. I'm not as rusty as I thought I would be. Of course, there are small details that I'm a bit not so clear on, but again, the more you train, the more those get worked out. So it's good to be back. My shoulders already gotten a little bit of stiffness, but again, we're just going to take an easy pace today. Luckily, my friend who introduced me here, Jessica,
hi.
Was kind enough to bring a lighter bow for me because, you know, I don't play this, you know, well, I'm a big macho former Marine and I gotta, you know, put up a front that I'm a big, you know, stud, can pull a, you know, very high kiloage, not poundage bow.
And you know, Kyudo is different to regular archery, so you can't be like, how many kilos do you pull, how many, what's your poundage, because it's a different shooting method altogether,
right?
So, yeah,
I did.
Starting light is really good.
Yeah, I didn't play that. I said, yeah, buy, you know, bring, you know, if you got, I've got everything except for a bow. I've got my own glove, arrows, everything. She just needed to hook me up with a bow. So they got
an
8 kilo one, you know, which normally a manly dude uses a higher poundage. But again, I'm getting back into it. So I have no shame in, you know, dropping to a lower weight to do the form correctly, because it's about the form. It's not about, you know, being a stud and how many kilo of a bow you can pull, etc. So, so to get back into the swing of thing, you know, lighter bow is better.
Yeah.
So thanks for
definitely. No worries, man. You did
and,
so good.
Yeah. Because this a little backstory. We've known each other through an internet forum. Living in Japan. And that, you know, this was before YouTube and all that, Facebook, before that was
before
a thing.
Before all social media was invented.
Old school forums, so that's how we got to know each other, met up, saw each other a couple times at, you know, the group parties and face-to-face, but then, you know, she had her
kids,
and so that obviously cuts down the party time, you know. And I... you know, was moving jobs here and there, so it's been, this is the first time we've seen each other
in
over 15 years or so. So
haven't changed, man.
Yeah, likewise, same here. And so, in case you don't know, which you should if you're interested in Japan, she is not only a natural beauty, but she's also on TV and is a true, indeed, actual talent. So she does lots of things for Saitama.
Yes.
That's where you live. So
yeah, that's right.
You've been like a representative
for them. Yes, I am the tourism ambassador for there. Yeah,
so,
I mean, hit up our Instagrams. Mm. I mean, you'll tag me and right, I'll tag right, you, right. And so, you'll be able to find us.
Yeah, so she's Jessica on, what is her YouTube channel?
So,
On your social media?
Instagram is Jess in Tokyo.
Okay, Jess in Tokyo.
One word, yeah. Right. So you can put in a name in there, and then, yeah, just please find me and follow me, and I'll follow you back.
Yeah, if you're not following her, you're wrong, okay? So she puts out a lot more stuff on Instagram than I do at this point. Like I said, she's got a lot of ambassador stuff, lots of Kyudo stuff.
Yeah.
So Jess in Tokyo on Instagram, and through that you can find her other social media.
Thank you so much.
Right, it's good to be back. Just to let you know, for those that want to join us that are in Japan, this is at the Akabane Sports Center in Kitzaku. So if you're in Japan and want to train, want to learn Kyudo, beginners are of course welcome. By all means, check out you, me, and Zen on Facebook. It does fill up early, so if you're interested, you need to get maybe about a month in advance is good advice, because they've only got so many slots for new people. But by all means, come and join us. So that was my first two shots after not having trained in Kyudo in over 15 years. And here's where they landed. My arrows aren't in the target, but at least I miss consistently in the same area in relation to the target. As far as being perfect, as my friend Jess said in the video, sure, all my movements were perfect. Let's go with that. I didn't take any more video than what you see here because I was there to train and to meet my friend Jess, who I had not seen in such a long time, so not to take pretty videos. New videos are already in the works. Teaser! And I've also been doing some kind of behind-the-scenes stuff, some of which you can see here. With some of those preparations completed, now it's time to execute on the reason I made the Bushido Devil Dog channel in the first place. Hold on, my voice is getting goofy. Let me take a drink here. One more. So I hope you'll hit that subscribe button, like the boss that we know you are, and stick around for more Bushido related content, more Devil Dog related content, and outdoor adventures, etc. See you soon. More Devil Dog related content, more outdoor. Yeah.